Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, as part of Android architecture series, we covered how MVP looks, that is model view presenter architecture, and we implemented that design pattern in a sample Android application. In MVP, presenter has a reference to the both view and model. The possibility of presenter becoming bloated is very high because it has got both reference to the model and view, and in mobile applications, the UI always changes. So as view changes, it will have an impact on the presenter, and presenter needs to change itself to cater to the needs of the view. And it also contains business logic other than dealing with the communication between the view and the model. And also you have to write too many presenters. For every view, you have a presenter. There is a one-to-one mapping between the view and the presenter. You cannot share a common presenter between multiple views. So this also makes your source code pretty large, or at least the number of classes that you will have to write, the number of classes that implement an interface will keep on increasing if you adhere to the model view presenter design pattern. And also, since there is a dual dependency of the presenter between the model and the view, unit testing of the presenter becomes a little bit complicated in this particular approach. But last but not the least, MVP breaks one of the major rule of clean code architecture. And what is that rule? Source code dependencies should only point inwards. Well, if you have been doing mobile application development in Android, and if you are a fan of writing clean code, I'm sure you might have come across Uncle Bob's clean code architecture. Well, as per this person's recommendation, the dependencies should always point inward. That is, the outer layers, the UI, can have the reference to the presenter. Presenter should not have the dependency of the UI. So it should always move from outer layer, that is UI, to presenter, and then to use cases, and finally the entities, the main data. And as you can see that the MVP is breaking this. In the MVP, the view is the outward layer because that is where flow starts from, and the model is basically the inward layer. So from view to presenter and from presenter to view is what we are good with. But what we should avoid is presenter to view and model to presenter dependencies. Now, how that design pattern would look like? Well, this is how it would look like. Right now, we have not given any name to the middle layer that sits between the view and the model. And also, it goes without much saying that the view has reference to the middle layer and the middle layer has the reference to the model. It is just that to keep visuals clean, I have not shown them explicitly. So this middle layer sits between the view and the model so that there cannot be a direct dependency between the view and the model. So how should the data flow would look like in this way of unidirectional dependency that we are trying to achieve? Let's assume that you have a text view on the view, in this case an activity, and in the model we have some data, probably integer number 1 we want to display on the text view. So what will happen is we will try to maintain a copy of that data from the model in this middle layer, and then the view will observe for any data changes that are happening in this particular middle layer through an observer design pattern. And if the data has changed in the middle layer, since it has subscribed to the changes that are happening in the middle layer, this one will be propagated to the text view and you can see that displayed in the text view. Not only that, there might be some application logic in the middle layer because of which the data might change. If that happens, because of the observer design pattern, the text view should automatically get updated. So if we try to summarize what this middle layer is trying to achieve, is it gives you the ability to adhere to the principles of clean code architecture. It provides a sufficient loose coupling between the view and the model. So what do I mean by this is you can observe that we can actually maintain a copy of the data that is there in the model and transform that data as per the needs of the view, and we can maintain that independent of the actual model, and the view can use that particular model from the middle layer without actually concerning itself about what actually is the data that is there in the innermost layer. And also the data that is being maintained in this particular middle layer is more catered towards the need of the view. So in a way, this particular middle layer is a model, but more concerned with the view. And that is why middle layer in this case is called as view model. Some people also refer to this particular design pattern as view binder model design pattern. And some people will also say that MVVM is actually an enhanced version of model view binder design pattern. So going forward, our discussion will be moving towards the MVVM architecture. And if you are wondering where this came from, this was actually a design pattern that was created by Microsoft. So if you are coming from .NET background, you would have already been familiar with this particular design pattern. This is not very new design pattern. It has been there in existence for quite some time. And MVVM was developed by Microsoft specifically to cater to the requirements of U interaction design pattern. And in Android also, we have pretty similar interaction pattern. It is no wonder that Android took to MVVM very easily. And people at Android have made quite a number of libraries and frameworks to implement MVVM in an Android application very easily. For example, you can see that the view needs to observe certain things that are there in the view model. In the same way, probably the view model needs to be aware of the life cycle of the activity, which is the view in an Android application. So that is why you will hear the terms like view model, live data, lifecycle owner, data binding, which are all part of Android architecture components that Android has created for the Android developers to implement MVVM seamlessly in an Android application. So any MVVM implementation in Android would not be complete without the discussion about some of these libraries, being aware of how to use them and how it works. So stay tuned for the upcoming tutorial videos in Android architecture series on MVVM design pattern. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.